coming up, you know we're getting close to pitchers and catchers reporting when the Mets broadcast trio of Gary, Keith, and Ron get together for a special honor. We'll hear from the best in the biz later in the show.
And for more on Daniel Jones, we welcome in our NFL insider, Connor Hughes. Connor, we know Jones switched agents. What we don't know is what's going on with the contract talks. Where do things stand right now?
Mentioned Mitchell Robinson. The Knicks are without him again, which allowed Nick Claxton to get a double-double. What stood out about how he contributed to the Nets win?
Late first period, game tied at one. Artemi Panarin takes a shot. Chris Kreider deflects it in. Rangers take a 2-1 lead. Kreider sets a Rangers franchise record with his 25th power play goal of the season.
Pens and the Canes, it's two very different matchups for the Rangers. New York holds a 2-1 series lead over Pittsburgh. It's skill versus skill. Pens aren't as deep. They've had injury issues, but they have experience, and they also have a guy named, Sidney Crosby.
Time to go around the rings with Binks. Beforehand, they had a lot of skill, but it was just about getting the pieces in the right place. So Vladimir Tarasenko is kind of like that corner piece in a puzzle where it just sort of helps fortify everything, really your top six at this point, because we did see that Panarin was demoted to the second line alongside Trocheck. He had been on the top line before. So now you have all these pieces in the top six.
Back to Toronto, top of seventh. Aaron Judge, no hits in three at-bats to this point. Judge facing Tim Mesa. And the hit the sports world has been waiting for. Judge hits home run number 61. He ties Roger Maris for the American League home run record. His mom and Roger Maris Jr. showing their excitement. His teammates all out of the dugout to greet him. Judge with a historic home run in Toronto. And here he is after the game.
It's an incredible honor.
We've been waiting for what seems like forever for this moment, but number 61 for Aaron Judge. JJ, to put it into context, how remarkable is this accomplishment?
Julia, I don't think this is exaggeration or hyperbole. It is the best season I have ever seen from a New York Yankee.
Now, let's welcome in the fourth member of our broadcast crew, Julie Stewart-Binks downstairs. Julie, welcome.
Well, Brendan, you guys were talking about John Cooper's demeanor, and I spoke about it with former NFL head coach Bruce Arians, who won a Super Bowl with the Buccaneers in 2020, the same year Cooper won his first Stanley Cup with the Lightning. He said he loves the John Cooper is always level-headed on the bench. He said he never changes his emotion. He's not yelling at players. He gives them information. He said he's the coolest, calmest coach that I've ever seen. I asked him, does he remind you of anyone in the NFL? And he said Bill Belichick, but Bill's a little bit more animated.
Well, thank you for that.
Auston Matthews, he's going to have to deliver. He's actually been very good in this series, certainly in game one. Had a couple goals there. Earlier, he spoke with Julie Stewart-Binks.
Auston, other than staying out of the box, what's something else you guys are keying in on for game three?
I mean, I think that was a big part of it.
How do you keep the foot on the gas?
Well, that's a good question. It's something that obviously a lot of teams, when they get up, they have a tendency to sit back.
So what's the message rest of the game?
Well, listen, this is far from over. This is the playoffs, so like nobody's coasting home here.
Now welcome in former Colombian international legend Juan Pablo Angel. And when we look at this list leading the way, Juan Pablo is Marcelo Martins with 8 goals. But for Bolivia, a limited chance to make the World Cup as it stands right now. Where does his motivation come from?
I mean, Julie, he is having a phenomenal tournament, and you cannot take anything away from him.
We saw his move to PSG. We saw Argentina win Copa America. It feels like there's a bit of a different energy with Lionel Messi. And Kaylin, what would you say would be Messi's evolution at this point with Argentina?
Defending World Cup champions France ended a streak of 3 straight champions going out in the group stage by advancing to the knockout round to face Poland, a team that's in the round of 16 for the first time since 1986. England and USA both opened their World Cup campaigns in very different ways. The Three Lions thrashed Iran 6-2, while the U.S. drew against Wales in what felt like a winnable match. Now the U.S. faces pressure to avoid a loss, which would leave knockout qualification in the balance.
Can we stop for a second? England scored 9 goals. 9 goals? It's not if they will win, it's how. Harry Kane isn't winning the Golden Boot, but he can still be effective. I like England to win, Harry Kane to assist or score, and over 2.5 goals. France will score first, but with Chesney in goal, they won't run up the score. I like France to win and Olivier Giroud to score, and also Kylian Mbappe with the brace has great value.
Both teams can win this, so look for value in props. I expect both teams to score, Antoine Griezmann to assist, and I like Messi and Mbappe anytime assist or scores. But this moment feels bigger for Argentina and Lionel Messi, and I'm sticking with my pre-tournament pick, and I expect Argentina to win the World Cup. For more World Cup odds, visit the FanDuel Sportsbook app.
Fantasy Football Happy Hour with Matthew Berry.
Well, we know that the Commanders are 1-0, and you're very happy
first
about that.
Place, Commanders.
But
thank
they
you
are
much.
Underdogs to the what Detroit the? Lions. I got a source who's telling me that they believe that Allen Robinson will see a lot more volume, and right. that also Sean McVay rarely calls out players. And he did call out Cam Akers before he had that nice motivational yeah. quote that you mentioned. He was saying, you know, we got to see some more from this guy. And I know listen, as a Commanders fan, though.
I was just going to say, if he needs to miss the game this week, I'm okay
it's
with
it. It's
got to
have changed the line because it was -2.5 before. It's -1.5 now.
I mean, because people are insane.
I literally came here from a task force meeting in our office and left the conference room to walk across town
really
to see
you. Really glad that I interrupted that,
that
meeting.
The meeting ended when I left.
Okay.
you know, listen, this is concerning, to be fair. New ground.
USA, Mexico, Dos Acero, so much history. For those that have played it and that have been on the pitch, maybe been at Azteca or whether you've welcomed Mexico to the U.S., what's something that those players and yourself understand about this rivalry that we could possibly never understand?
I think it's a great question. What gets misconstrued in the public is in order to hate someone, you have to respect somebody. And I think that gets lost.
G7 got underway yesterday with countries like Iceland, Wales, Belgium, and Italy all securing important victories, while the Netherlands sunk deeper into crisis. And the action continues today all across Europe with plenty more drama in store. Things haven't gone so well for some of the British teams in this tournament. Liverpool and Tottenham both out in the round of 32, which means Everton, surprisingly, is carrying the flag for England now, Warren.
And sadly, I would like to say as well, sadly.
That's what they pride themselves on. And we saw, you know, Rapinoe going out, but Kristen Press, who would be a starter on literally any other team in the World Cup, comes in and almost tactically benefited them because she's so quick. She has such a great work rate. She came in, and there were concerns about England, one of England's outside backs, Lucy Bronze, well, there was no problem. You know, in the 10th minute, she's able to connect on that header. And she did dedicate it to her mother, who tragically just passed away for years. But also in this World Cup in particular, the women have had to break societal constructs of how you should act when you celebrate goals, you know, how you should act if you are allowed to be a little bullish as it pertains to social media and quotes and standing up for yourself. And so when I look at this team, I get inspired. I mean, they're so powerful, they're so strong on the pitch, but they are role models for everyone in this world.
But Jozy Altidore was beaming talking about having Clint back. He missed having that strike partner up top, but he also said Clint brings a new energy to this group right now. He's a fun guy, he makes jokes, but he's an American warrior. He knows what it means to win for his country, and that inspires guys at a very pivotal point. Now, the U.S. attack will also have Jozy Altidore available for tonight's game. He missed the friendly against Venezuela, attending his brother's wedding in Ireland. He leads the U.S. all-time in scoring against the Soka Warriors with 5 goals. Tony.
I spoke with Josh Williams, who told me if he wasn't on this field playing for the Columbus Crew tonight, he would be up in these stands showing support for the team and for the city. He said, I have been an Ohio kid forever. I have grown up supporting this club for 10 years. Tonight is all about showing pride for this city. He said, I want people to recognize the players on the field stand with the fans. Clint, congratulations. We see you really enjoying this moment with your family, with the fans. I know you weren't able to be a part of it last season. What does it mean to experience this now?
Oh, it's great. I mean, it's great for the city.
Well, thank you so much, Max. Now, the biggest difference with the conditions this year is that the field is in much better shape. Last year, it was a quick turnaround after hosting Grey Cup. There was sand and spray paint filling in the holes, but I spoke with a groundskeeper who said there's absolutely no extra sand on the pitch. The conditions are 80% better than they were last year.
We've been told that suspended China head coach Hao Wei will be sitting in the auxiliary press box to the left of the commentary position for what should be the duration of the match. Coach Norio Suzuki said his team doesn't need any extra motivation, but admitted with Ondo back, it has made a huge difference. And although she won't be able to contribute on the pitch, we're told she'll take her place on the bench next to a white teddy bear that has embodied her spirit through this tournament all the way to the World Cup final.